one of the most priceless human gifts is that of friendship. It allows us to disclose ourselves to and receive from another in complete openness and trust. We can think aloud before a friend. With a friend, we can participate in one another's joys and sorrows, hopes and fears. A friend allows us to survive loneliness, indifference, hostility. Before a friend, we can make a mistake and not be shamed. We can be accepted for who we are. With a friend, we can always be beautiful in our inner core. In good times and bad, a friend is simply there. Today, Jesus invokes this precious relationship between human beings. He draws on the wisdom tradition that sings the praises of a true friend. He stands in the tradition that recognized in Abraham and Moses men who were friends of God, two who walked with God, who spoke with God, as one speaks with a friend. Today, we hear Jesus name his disciples, my friends. A clear hint of how he is related to his disciples. Not they, not servants, but friends with whom he could share everything. In John's Gospel, Jesus is not without friends. We have found them along the way. John the Baptist is called the friend of the bridegroom. And then there is that family at Bethany, Martha, Mary, and Lazarus. Jesus did more than simply get a free meal from time to time. No, they were the friends of Jesus. He could banter with them. For Lazarus, his friend, he could weep. And then call him forth from the grave, because that's what a friend does. Stands with the other in death and calls them forth again into the light, and then helps them to unbind and go free. At the heart of friendship is love. Today we hear Jesus wanting to draw his disciples into his experience of love. He wants to give them his gift of love. He wants to draw them into a circle of friendship, a circle of love. In friendship, the focus is on the other, not to get something from them, not even to receive something from them, but to give to them, to be for them, to be all for them. For Jesus' experience of love, it begins with the Father. He says it over and over, I remain in my Father's love. The Father loves me, and so I'm not alone. It might look to you as if I'm alone, but I'm not alone. How does Jesus know that he's in the Father's love? He says, because I keep the Father's commandment to love. And that commandment is rather simple. Jesus is the one the Father sends into the world so that the world may have life to the full. We know that phrase very well. God loved the world so much, he sent his only Son. The two key words, God's relationship to the world, love. And that love is manifested in sending his only Son. God loved the world, and so he sent his most precious and only relationship into the world. And Jesus? Jesus obeys the Father's desire to send love into the world and give it a human face. Jesus obeys the Father's will that sends him into the world to love the world. Or as he says, to give his very flesh full for its life. Jesus speaks today of two qualities of this divine loving. One is that love lays down its life for its friends. Jesus will lay down his life for his disciple friends. He will hold nothing back from them. He will love them to the end, literally love them to death. The other quality is a hallmark of all good friendship. Friends share their thoughts and heart with one another. And so Jesus shares the Father's love with his disciples. Jesus keeps no secrets. What the Father has told Jesus in his bosom, he shared with his disciples. What good works we have seen that Jesus has done, they are the works of the Father, and they've been done in front of his disciples. What they see and hear is from Jesus is in reality who and what the Father is. The loving that has been going on between Jesus and the Father, Jesus now shares with his disciple friends. Jesus cannot keep that loving relationship to himself. The love he knows has become a commandment. Translate that as, it's become his motivation. It's what moves him to act. And so he must love his own in this world. He knows the Father's love, and so he must love. If Jesus is to love completely and truly be the Father's love in the world, then he has no choice but to die. He must lay down his life for his friends. Love must be total, an outpouring of life for the other, no holding back. And so Jesus comes to understand that his dying is not an empty death. He's not just another victim, unjustly caught in a web of violence. His dying is a choice. I choose to lay down my life. Another way of saying, I choose to love. My love is freely given. It's not pulled out of me. God is love, we heard today in John's first letter. If God is love, then he chooses to love, and he does that in and through his Son. And his Son chooses to love by embracing a death that is violent, unjust, and humanly cruel. God's love, John says, is revealed by sending his Son to embrace our world of sin. In embracing it, his love breaks its power and releases us from sin's claim on us. Only a love that will join us in death and in sin is a love that can gift us with freedom. We usually hold back when we love. We keep something for ourselves, but not with Jesus and his friends. He walks with us all the way. There's a chain of love being proclaimed today. It's being proclaimed as the heart of the mystery of the one who we so easily call God, but whom Jesus called Father, because everything came from him. The chain of love begins with the Father, whose name we heard today is love. This love is poured into the Son, who activates it and makes it real before our very eyes. How? By laying down his life for those of us from whom life has slipped away. And before Jesus enters into this laying down of his life, as the disciples are gathered around the table of the Last Supper, Jesus shares the mystery of that love with those whom he calls his friends. He wants to call the disciples into that circle of loving, since they're the ones he's dying for. For you I am dying, he says. Receive this love as new life. If you accept my love for you, then you will know that you too must love in the same way. My loving you unto death becomes a commandment, a motivation for you to do the same to one another. Jesus is expounding on the mystery we had on Holy Thursday. He's the master who washed our feet. But listen to us. We protested. We didn't want him to touch our feet. Accepting love is hard. But if we will not let him wash our feet, translate, die for us, then we will not accept this death. And that we can have, as he says, no part with him. A friend of Jesus is also a friend who will die for others. Obeying the command to love begins by accepting love. Jesus is talking to us today. He says, I learned loving from my Father. It means dying for those that he and I love. Now it's your turn. You learn loving from me and exercise that love to one another. Dying means giving all to the very end. Now each of you must give your all for one another. When others see that way of giving all to one another without limit, then will the face of the Father, the God of love, be visible in the world. Then will the chain of love become the real thread that binds all humanity together. Then will the divisions and boundaries in this world break down. Then heaven and earth will not be strangers to one another, but be friends who know what it is to be loved, and so love without bounds. And as we heard in Acts, follow the lead of the Spirit who holds all things in one. There's no limit to God's love, no limit to Jesus' dying. It embraces all. His command to us is that, grounded in that limitless love, we do the same.